Hello friends, in this video we will be discussing about the concept of file management, and in file management we will be discussing about how to write numbers into the file. In the previous videos, using online compiler, we have seen that how to write string or the content into a file, or we have seen that how to copy the content of one file into other file. Right now I am taking this ball and compiler just to make you aware that syntactically and logically there isn't any difference between online compiler or this compiler, so that the program of writing numbers into the file, this we are going to demonstrate using this particular compiler. So first of all, we know that we need to open a file. So before that, what we need to do, we need to create the object of a predefined structure named as file. So this capital file is a predefined structure, so we have created two objects of it. After that, I am storing the whole array, so that's why I have taken a static array in which I have taken numbers 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and these numbers I am going to store into my file. Now, in file management, the first operation which we are supposed to do is the opening the file. So we have written fp1 equals to a function fopen. It contains two parameters. The first parameter will be the file name, and the second parameter is the mode. So here the mode is W. It means I am opening this file into write mode, since I need to write numbers into the file. Then this is I mentioned to manage the error, if any. This will be there to check out if the file which we are trying to open cannot be opened by the system due to any technical reason, then the file pointer is pointing to null. So that we are checking if file pointer is pointing to null, means the file which we are trying to open is not opened successfully, so that we cannot continue with our process. So to manage the error or to handle the error, we have written this code that if file pointer equals to null, then we will be printing the message that error in opening the file. And if this is not the case, then what we can go for? We can go for the actual code. Now in actual code, what we are trying to do? We are trying to write the numbers into the file. How many numbers we have? So since we have 5 numbers, we have written for loop right now. And then put W function is used to write numbers into the file. Here the meaning of W is word. Now this word is not the word which is used in English. This word is the word which we are using in the binary terminologies, that bit, then byte, bytes, words. So that type of word it is. Okay. So put W is writing the number into the file. Again, it takes two parameters. The first parameter is the number which is to be written inside the file, and the second is the file pointer in which this particular number is to be returned. Now this statement or this particular body is to be repeated for 5 times. Why 5 times? Because our loop is running for 5 times. So likewise, it will be storing all 5 numbers, 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50, all 5 numbers into the file1.txt. After that, I am closing that file, fclose fp1. Now I am opening the same file again to read the content from it, because now I need to make the sum of the numbers which are stored inside the file. Again, I repeat, I need to make the sum of the numbers which are stored inside the file. So I am opening that same file in which mode? Read mode. Okay. Again, I am checking the condition whether the file opened successfully or not. If it is not opened successfully, then file pointer should point to null. But if it is opened successfully, then the file pointer is pointing to a particular file. Now to read the data or read the number from the file, this is the function getW. get is to take, w is the word. So it will be reading a number from the file or whole word from the file, and will be storing that number into variable I. Now this condition is mentioned that we will be repeating this particular loop until and unless we reach to end of file. Now we know that likewise string, like in string, string is terminated by null character. Likewise, file is terminated by end of file, a special character named as end of file. So the whole condition means that whatever the value we are getting from the file or reading from the file, if that value is not equals to end of file, then we will be continuing with the loop. So it means that this loop will be terminated when you will reach, or the file pointer will reach to end of file. Now for all short of iterations, what we are supposed to do? We are supposed to make the sum, because whatever the value we are reading will be stored in I, and then after what we are doing, we are making the sum of those numbers, and finally we close the file and we print the sum by printf on the screen. So this is how this program gets executed. Now I execute this code, Control F9. So you can see here, we can get answer sum of numbers is 150. Now if I am changing one of the value over here, suppose I am putting 400 and 350, now I am executing the same code. So you can see the answer is changed. Okay, so sum of numbers is 810. So this is how you can able to read and write numbers into the file. I hope you understood this concept. Thank you for watching the video.